clearly, Casey has not told the truth about every subject over these last several months. You still in your heart believe that your daughter had nothing to do with the disappearance of Caylee?
I believe Caylee is with someone that Casey had trusted, and I believe that Casey had been betrayed.
And Caylee, little Caylee, was always well-dressed and well-taken care of, and then she vanishes, but Casey sticks around.
Casey has done nothing to her daughter. There's no evidence that shows that.
Evidence that was found in the car, a speck of something that might be blood, some hair, and some dirt.
Captain Angelo Nieves from Orange County Sheriff's Office gave an official public statement stating the FBI has provided scientific evidence of human decomposition in the trunk of Casey Anthony. Point blank, I just read it.
Hair follicle or whatever. None of that's been verified.
From the FBI lab?
Your forensic specialist himself said none of that's been verified.
Samples. He did not say, he said some of the evidence he would want to verify before he gave his expert opinion. But the FBI crime lab states point blank that there is scientific evidence of human decomposition in Casey's car trunk.
I would love to know what it is. Are we talking about urine? I mean, I've myself put dirty diapers back there from Caylee until we'd gotten home and thrown them away.
When I finally met up with Casey, she said that Caylee was with the babysitter, Zanny.
Caylee wasn't with her like she had told me she was with her for the last month.
But whose fault is you sitting in the jail? You're blaming me that you're sitting in the jail?
Not
blame yourself
fault.
For telling lies.
She has been more of a victim from the media and from the local authorities, almost as much as poor Caylee.
You don't know what my involvement is in stuff?
Casey.
Mom.
What?
No.
I don't know what your involvement is, sweetheart. You're not telling me where she's at.
Because I don't f***ing know where she's at. Are you kidding me? Liz, I don't want to talk to you right now. Forget it. I called to talk to my mother, and it's f***ing waste. Oh, by the way, I don't want any of you coming up here when I have my first hearing for bond and everything else. Like, don't even waste your time coming up here.
If anything happens with Casey, I'll die. Do you understand? I'll die. If anything happens to that baby.
Oh my God. Calling you guys? Waste. Huge waste.
Well, how come everybody's saying you're lying?
Because nobody's listening to anything that I'm saying.
They said that the person that you dropped Caylee with doesn't even exist.
Because, oh look, they can't find her in the Florida database.
My mommy told me something that little girl should know. It's all about the devil, and I've learned to hate him so. I know he'll be unhappy, 'cause I'll never wear a frown. Maybe if we keep on smiling, he'll get tired of hanging round. So let the sun shine in.
There were reports, photo shots, I think, of your daughter partying and the like and out having a good time during all this while her daughter's missing. Explain that.
There was one photo out of all the photos that have been showed of her partying that was after June 16th. There was one photo.
There is no concern, and she has had this behavior from the first phone call until these photos that were released just moments ago. I mean, some of the photos that I took a look at, I mean, we're seeing one was called Moon. Use your own description on that one.
I was even here just for the 9/11 tapes we're at, and I was sick as I started getting sicker because then they're telling me about photos about my daughter. You know, and I'm like, oh my gosh, what else is going on here?
Isn't it true that Casey Anthony, after little Caylee went missing, invited you out to that hot body contest. Do you remember when that was?
I know it was between the 9th of June and the 25th, because from the 9th to the 25th was when she was actually contacting me about going out pretty much 2 days, 3 days a week.
Tonight On the Record brings you exclusive information from the DJ from the club where those pictures you saw were taken of Casey Anthony partying when she told everybody else she was looking for her daughter. When he realized Caylee was gone and Casey wasn't really looking for Caylee, as far as he could tell, he got really scared. He's a little freaked out tonight, to be honest with you.
There was one photo.
One thing I find interesting about the feds being involved with this, you can easily lie to a state police officer, as the grandmother has done in this case. But you lie to a federal officer during the investigation, no matter how small, they can come after you.
There's no evidence that Casey has ever done any harm to her child. She is not dead. The washing of the pants, which clearly smelled like the car, by your client's admission, the car smelled like a dead body. Many people have suggested that your client did that knowingly.
Last half hour, we learned Cindy Anthony removed several items from her daughter's car, including a doll belonging to Caylee.
The car, in and of itself, the odor is its own animal, it's its own issue.
Right.
But what may have been in that vehicle at that time that we don't have, or that may have been removed from the car, with no malice, but just, I'm curious, I know there was a couple pairs of shoes, and some slacks, right, and the baby chair, yeah, the doll.
The doll.
Is there a diaper bag in the car?
I believe it could have been in the trunk of the car. I'm not sure if it was in the trunk or was in the rear seat area. It was another one of her backpacks.
But not the one with the monkeys on it that you're talking about?
Not that I can know, because the one she had the monkeys on was white. I'm positive of that.
We don't know where that backpack is at all.
But I know it was white because I know she had it on. It's fairly new, as a matter of fact. I just got to tell you my feelings are. I don't like the Target. If I'm not,
I don't like the smell in the car.
I'm being straight with you guys.
We didn't like the smell.
With my wife's money. I'm being straight and honest. I know in the trunk.
I don't like the
smell in the car.
I think you're a guy that does a lot of things.
We have these collapsible crates. It was a blue one. The color had coat hangers. Just a bunch of miscellaneous little stuff in the back of it.
Nothing removed above and beyond what was recovered already?
Not that I can remember. But then again, after we brought our car home, my wife sent me back to work. And she said, I'll handle everything with Casey.
Casey has done nothing to her daughter. There's no evidence that shows that.
But then again, after we brought our car home, my wife sent me back to work.
Everybody will know that my daughter is innocent.
I said, wait a second. I said, where's Caylee? What's going on? Oh, she's staying with Zanny. And I said, you know, we've been seeing the girl in over a week, you know, how's everything? We haven't talked to her. It's really nice to hear her little voice. Dad, I only got time for it. I got 10 minutes. I got to get back to work.
She has been more of a victim.
My dad was in the car business. I know a lot about cars, and it just, we could have got stunned down locally.
I think you're a guy that knows a lot about a lot of things, George.
Yeah.
But then again, after we brought our car home, my wife sent me back to work.
I think you're a guy that knows a lot about a lot of things, George.
Yeah.